Thank you guys for joining today. We are going to do an overview of Unity. We're going to walk you through it. You're going to know all about it by the time we're done. What is Unity? How to get it? How it works? Understanding the interface, bringing in assets, installing a text editor, writing simple scripts, where to go, and how to continue learning. Unity is a game engine, but it's also used for a lot of other stuff. It's being used for things like architectural visualization, for animation and cinematics, special effects. It's a great way to create interactive programs to train people. I work in Unity every day. I love it. I use it for game development. Now that you know what Unity is, you might be wondering, Lena, how do I get Unity? The answer is you go to unity.com. Here's a website. You can click on the Get Started button. And here are the commercial products. I have Plus, okay? Kind of a pro over here. I'm already a Plus user, okay? If you're just starting off, you can use the personal edition until have a revenue or funding of over 100,000 in a year. Then you need to upgrade. And to get it, you just click on Get Started. And you're gonna wanna get the Unity Hub. So download. So this is what it looks like, okay? It's this little window here that pops up, and it's kind of like you're about to open a program. But if you don't have Unity installed yet, you're gonna need to do that first. When you get this for the first time, there should be an add button where you can add a version of Unity. You can go to your installs as well and install the editor. Once you start making projects, this is where they show up. This is the name of them, the file location, when you last modified them, but also importantly, the version number of that project. So you might have games using different version numbers, which is why the hub is so important. Let's look at how Unity works. We're going to start off by making a new project together. This will take a second to put together. We're going to click New Project. Carding microgame, 2D mobile, first person microgame. So there's a lot of stuff here you can choose from. We're gonna click a blank 3D project, which is 3D core. Unity demo project, and I'm gonna put in a folder that makes sense for me. And now it's gonna create that project. The next thing we're gonna cover before we start using this and looking closely at it is how Unity works. You will be using C# in Unity, okay? So even though it's built in C++, that's all the behind the scenes stuff. You don't need to worry about it. We're focusing on C# when we're using Unity. You're gonna need something to write your code in. You can use an IDE, Integrated Development Environment, or you can use a text editor. They're both of them you write code in. I use VS Code. We're gonna look at that shortly. All the items in your game are called game objects. Game objects have a position, they have a size, and you can add on something called components, kind of like modular pieces that you can attach to a game object, and that will give it its properties. So whether it has a renderer, which allows you to see it, or a collider, which allows you to bump into it, these types of properties are all within a component, and you can change those values of that game object within that component's details. Let's look at the interface. Isn't it beautiful? Now, here it says the name of my scene, sample scene. We have our game objects that are in the scene here. And if we click on one of them, on the right over here is our inspector tab. This shows all the properties of our game objects here in our hierarchy. So this is what's in our game. In the current scene, you could put your whole game into one scene. If it's a more complex game, you might want to have different scenes. This scene will be our whole game. The hierarchy shows all the game objects in that particular scene. And our project folder down here you can see, lists the assets that's in our project folder. So these aren't necessarily being used in the game when they're in our folder, but they're available for us to use if we want to. So we can drag items from our scene into our hierarchy, and that's how you bring them into the scene. So we can right click over here in the hierarchy. We can select 3D object, and then we can select cube. You can use a mouse wheel to scroll in and out. Now you see this cube in the world. This is in our scene view here. Scene view is the middle thing that has all the developer information. It's not going to look as good as your full game, but you can turn on the lighting, you can turn off the lighting, you can change the angles, you can look at it in all different ways. This is our scene view, it's where we do our work. When we play the game, we're playing in game view, and this is a preview of our current camera's view and what you'll see if you play the game. Our directional light here, you can see the color blue. We can change things in its properties. Going into some of these values, we can change the intensity. You can see it's being reflected on this cube here, higher, lower. And on the cube, you can also change things like the scale. So we can set it to be 100 by 100. Now you have a ground. This is a position right in the middle of the scene, 0, 0, 0. On the cube, we have the mesh render, which shows the cube, and the box collider so that things will collide with it and we can actually have physics basically taking place with that object. Next, we're going to start looking at controlling items within the scene view a little bit more. So let's add another cube by right-clicking on our hierarchy, selecting 3D object, and selecting cube. So now we have a cube on our cube. You can see that this has what's called a manipulator, which is this three arrows in different directions. When it's set to the three arrows, that means you can use those to move it, and that will affect the position over here. When you select it, it will turn on. And then if they're not showing up when you click it, you press W. If you press E, you now have your rotation options here. And finally, R will bring up the ability to scale your object. So you can do these with the number values over here, or you can do them with the manipulators to do it kind of more visually. You can also see me here moving around the scene like this. This is something I use a lot. You can do that by holding Alt down and then using your left mouse button in order to get the different views and kind of check things out. Middle mouse button scrolls in and out, and middle mouse button down and drag is how you pan around the scene. You can also do like a pivot view with your right mouse button. I don't really use this one that much, but it might be useful to you. And if you get far away from your object and you're like, oh no, click the object you want to focus on and press letter F and it will zoom right in and center in the middle of your screen. We're gonna next look at the bringing objects in from the asset store. There's a tab here open called asset store. If you don't see it, you can click window asset store and you can scroll around and see what's here. You can search for something you want. You can click on pricing and select free assets. We're gonna click free assets. Let's click on the low poly tree pack, add to my assets, accept. Now it's adding and I can open in Unity, open Unity editor. There it is, low poly tree pack. There it is at the bottom of the list. Okay, so now that we can see it in our package manager, we can click download. That'll bring it into our project. Import, import again. This shows you the files that are listed. So now we can close our package manager. And over here, we can see that we have some files added in our assets folder, in our project folder here. And within it, we see different items. So if we click on prefabs and they're all set to go. So we're gonna drag one in. We can either drag it from our project folder into our scene or into our hierarchy. Let me show you both. So we drag one here into our scene. We can position it. Or we can drag it into our hierarchy, and that brings it into the middle of the scene, the origin. We can then move it around. So you can go ahead and decorate some scenes right off the bat. It's really fun to play around in. We're gonna look at some basic scripting, okay? One thing you're gonna wanna do next is install a text editor or IDE so that you can code. So we're gonna use VS Code, which I really love working with. You can link Unity to it using going to Edit, Preferences, External Tools, and then you can select it from the list. You may have other ones installed. You can choose which you'd like. I'm using Visual Studio Code. Here it is on the list, and that will link together so that when you make a script, you can click on it and it will automatically open that program. We're going to right-click in our project folder and create our first script. So right-click on the project folder, select Create, C# script. Here we have a file with a big hashtag on it, and we're going to write color change. Now we have a name for it. We double click it. Once you have your text editor or IDE integrated with Unity linked together, it will automatically open up when you double click this script. And this is what a default script looks like in Unity. You'll notice it says color change here. You want to make sure that this word here, this whatever this says, matches identically to the name of the file, because otherwise you're going to come into some problems. These are some of the libraries that we're using with Unity by default. You're probably going to keep them there for the most part. We're going to do a simple script where we change the color of this cube. As you can see right now, with the lighting being pink, it's kind of hard to tell. So we're going to just set the lighting to be white. We're going to change the color of it. To do that, we're going to apply two different materials. We're going to right-click in our project folder, create material. We're going to call one red, and here is our red material. We double-click it, or if we click on it, here's the properties of it. Set the albedo here, click on that, and we're going to set it to red. Now that you see this updated as red in here, we can drag it onto our cube here or over here. And now that game object has that material as a component. Now we're going to create another one. We can click on that, press Control D, and we've duplicated it. Now we have red and red one. Rename this to blue. We can then click on it, make sure it's selected, and change our color to a blue color. We want to do that with script. We want to do that in code. The first thing we want to do is be able to grab the cube so that we know that what we're changing in the script, let's say serialize fields. So here's the cube, and we can drag this script onto the cube just like we did with the material. And you can see that here, color change script. And there's no properties yet, it's just a blank script. So now if we select serialize field and type game object, capital G, capital O, and we're gonna say cube and then semicolon. That's all the script we need for this to now have property that we can fill in when we select it again. You can see here, cube, none, game object. So it's looking for game object, there's nothing here. What we can do is take this cube over on our hierarchy and drag that over here. And now our script is gonna be connected with this cube. From here, we can now change properties of this cube with this script. We're going to serialize two more fields, and they're both going to be materials because we want to be able to change them. So let's serialize field. We say material, we'll say red, and then comma blue. Now there's two separate ones. The comma will separate different materials that you want to add to this. So these are now added. We have all three items connected to our script. Now let's tell it to do something. So what we're going to do is when our mouse clicks in the scene, we want the color to change. So in order to check when the mouse is being clicked, we need to be checking on each frame for it. So we're going to say void because it's not returning everything. Most things, if you don't return something, it's just going to have void in front of it. So we're going to say void update, and that is the function you run that will happen on each frame. Now you can say cube get component. So now we can get the component that we had listed over here, and we want to get the renderer because that's what you change when you change material. So it's written like this, get component in brackets with more brackets afterwards. So we're going to put cube transform, and then we're going to say material equals blue. Okay, so we need to call this. If we do this, it will happen right away, and it will happen every frame. If input get mouse button down, then we can put that within the brackets. Now it should only happen once we click. So now we can click our scene and it should change to blue. There we go. Very good. We're gonna do one more little thing just to give you a little bit more insight in the code. We're going to create something called a bool or boolean. And because we haven't serialized it, it won't show up in our properties, but we don't need it to. And then we're going to call, so this is the type, and we're going to say is red. And we're going to set it equal to true when we start because we're starting it as red. And now we can set another if statement here. So when we press the mouse button down, we can say if is red. And then within that, we set it to blue. Else, so like otherwise, we can set the cube to red. So very similar, we can copy and paste this code. So now every time you click it, it will go back and forth as long as we change this bool. So if it's red, we now need to say if is red is true, we're going to set is red to false. And then if it's false and we go to the else case, we're going to want to set it to true again. So now we have it set up. It should go back and forth. Wow. Look at that. What a great game. So hopefully that all made sense. I know it's a lot to take in. Unity is, there is so much that goes into game development. You could publish your first game within a few hours of learning. It would probably be something very simple, maybe a little bit more than this. You can get started and it can be a really fun and fulfilling hobby. I always recommend people to get into Unity, try it out. Everything's free and there's so many resources available to see if you like it, because why not? It doesn't take long and it can potentially be a lot of fun.